Hello and welcome to my reaction to episode 16 of Last Exile. Last episode was very, very dense after so many episodes of just action with no answer to any mystery or anything like that. We're getting a ton last episode, plus a lot of good setup for character drama I actually like, and mainly it ended with can never remember her name. Sophia kissing Klaus for a reason. Also, it was implied that she might be a princess. And there was a lot more going on. Seems like Lavi and Tatiana like Klaus. There's so much going on. Let's just watch it. You've seen the episode. You know, like me, what's going on. Episode 16 in 3. 2, 1. Oh, she's leaving. Okay. What the fuck? Can anyone explain anything? Just waiting for explanation, I mean. What else can I do? I was checking I really like the character design, so I was checking what else this guy has done. Murata Renge. And yeah, I might react to some of his shit and seeing that there's something that I haven't seen yet, but I have the DVD of Blue Submarine number 6. It's 4VA. I think I'll watch that. He's also done some other stuff. I see something called BIM from 2018 that I dropped. ID0 that I dropped. Shangri-La. I mean, I really like his character design. Obviously, it's different than the show actually being good or something. Breakthrough. There's a lot going on suddenly. That's why. Does he not know? Alright, but how the fuck did that happen? How did she end up on this ship? What the fuck? Okay. The daughter of the Emperor as a spy. Guess the kiss was like, how do you call it? Basically, she could tell she couldn't get anywhere with the captain and she was feeling terrible, so she just did it for, I don't know, hurting herself or something? I don't know. It's pretty dense, but I think this is not too hard to understand. Okay. I was actually expecting her to kind of come back to being a kind of a bitch when she came back on the ship, but just a bit less. But no, she's really like totally like this exterior of being a bitch just totally was shredded. Yeah, right. Really. I guess I totally misunderstood because I was shipping him with Levi since they had a great scene. Okay. I forgot that, yeah, he said that he liked her. Man, the fucking relationship chart is starting to get pretty insane. So this old man is the confidant. Still hasn't returned it. You've heard about knocking. You can always make another one. This fucking mask. That's the girl we saw before. I was thinking she was going to be important, but she didn't even have a line. Oh shit, it's terrible, terrible outfit. I don't think you would care about your opinion when you just came back. Now she's the princess captive in the tower waiting to be rescued. Really. How cliche. Will the prince come? I assume. That is not very nice for privacy. Yeah. Gonna try to do a coup. Nothing new. It's true, she doesn't know. How does a flit sneak up? Well, shit. They keep showing this girl, so she has to be important in some way. It's crazy how fast things are moving now compared to the first half of the show. Okay. Fair enough. So they killed each other. Okay. Things are moving so fast. Once again, things are moving so freaking fast. Exactly. It has a story with you, so it's yours. It's not someone else. Well, can't blame it too much. Things have become pretty complicated. Once again, I'm kind of baffled so far in the second half of the show. The first half was very straightforward, like very simple. It was always everything led to a battle, and there's never any answer for any of the question. And then the last three episodes have been just everything happens, all the answer, way more question, some new stuff that we didn't think about, like Sophia being a fucking royalty and a spy, and everything's happening at once. All the character drama that, I mean, this show didn't seem like it was going to really have. It's just happening now. I like it. I just think it's kind of weird. I don't know that, but I'd assume something like they changed the writer midway, because it feels so different from the first half. There's so much happening. And it's much more interesting. Not that I didn't enjoy when it was just, you know, action, but yeah. Alright. Yeah, I don't even know where to begin. Well, I guess, I mean, I don't even know what to say, is more what I wanted to say. There's just so much, just this thing, for example, of Sophia being the daughter of the Emperor and on the ship at first to be a spy, and this went just so fast into episode, the reveal of it, the kissing of Klaus, then she goes back to the Emperor. Then she's imprisoned, and when she goes into the tower, I'm assuming, you know, she's gonna get rescued in one or two episodes by Alex. But nope, right away some shit happened and she's out again. Like, yeah, it's like the pace is went from like level 10 to level 50 or something. The pace just jumped. I like it, you know. I enjoy what's happening. Especially the drama between the character, I do think it's pretty good. You know, like Tatiana's reason for how she became like this, why now she's into Klaus. Lavi, same, why she's into Klaus, I guess, and a problem with Tatiana being into Klaus, and yeah, I think that's some good shit. I do like it. Anyway, thanks for watching, see you in the next one.